11957 Renato Coronado Corona, special time deposit, opening date May 16, 2007, opening balance 2 million pesos. Is that a correct reflection of your records?
It's in the document, yes, Your Honor.
By the way, this certification does not contain any signature. And there's a statement here, this is a system-generated certification and requires no signature. Even if without any signature, you confirm that this is a document coming from your bank.
Yes, Your Honor.
Now, in the last hearing, Senator Osmeña asked that any and all accounts, time deposits, certificates of deposits, and other such financial instruments offered by the PS Bank be produced. Are you aware of this?
The gentleman is given an extension of 2 minutes.
I have no more questions, Your Honor. I was just asking that in behalf of Senator
Smith. Yes.
Your Honor, please, at this juncture, may we be allowed to be informed whose witness is the witness on the stand, Annabel Johnson, because the prosecution never claimed that this witness is their witness, Your Honor. Neither is the defense. All the while, I thought, Your Honor, we were of the impression that he was summoned in order for this honorable court to gather information as to whether there had been leakage of the bank records, despite the confidentiality of the said records, Your Honor.
That's true. The purpose of the this gentleman and from Iloilo asked for from this witness whether, because he was the one subpoenaed by the court to bring the documents, whether she brought the documents subpoenaed, and that's why he was asking questions.
I'm only asking, Your Honor, if it is allowable under the rules of this impeachment court, whether this witness is a witness for the prosecution, because he's not our witness. So he must be the witness of Senator Drilon, Your Honor.
Can we respond, sir? Yeah. Can we respond?
The gentleman from Iloilo.
The witness was subpoenaed not for the purpose of examining her on the alleged leakage. Pages 17 and 19 of the records of the Senate of the last session will clearly show that the ruling of the chair was that the subpoena issued was for the purpose, was included the original and certified true copy of the opening documents, and the numbers and the account numbers were enumerated, and the Senate President ordered the clerk court to issue the subpoena. This is not a subpoena asking the witness whether on the matters pertaining to the alleged leakage. We were asking the questions in the course of our time as to whether or not she complied with former witness complied with the subpoena on bringing the original and certified true copies of the opening documents. And that was precisely the subpoena issued by the Senate President. So it has nothing to do with the leakage, and we said we need this information.
Your Honor, please. I do not know whether the defense lawyer will be allowed to engage in an argument with the Honorable Impeachment Judge, Your Honor. Because if we argue, Your Honor, then we will be ruled as out of order. But here is a witness who had been examined by the Honorable Drilon. We do not know whose witness he is and what will be the value of her testimony. Otherwise, Your Honor, we will move to strike out all the testimony of the witness. There is nobody. We cannot even prosecute her for perjury or falsification, Your Honor. Because nobody claims her to be a witness. There is, we are not in conformity, Your Honor, to the fact that the only purpose in calling this witness is to produce the documents mentioned in the subpoena. We are very clear and we stand pat on this manifestation, Your Honor. That, in fact, the president of the PS Bank, Your Honor, was ordered to produce Mrs. Chongson, Your Honor, because allegedly, the court has information to the effect that there were leakages in this case, and therefore, if there were, there is therefore that violation of the bank secrecy law, and any and all evidence presented towards that direction is subject to a motion to strike out, Your Honor. That is the rules of evidence we have understood. That is the rules of evidence in this country, and I suppose even this impeachment court will be governed
that's
by that rule.
That's correct, Your Honor. Yes, that's the
President.
That is the recollection also of the chair.
Sir President.
The records will bear that out.
Sir President, just on that point.
Yes.
Sir President, it's good that the good justice Cuevas brought that out, because that's the point I missed out a while ago on the defense panel press con last night. Umaangal din sila na may nagsabi po, hindi ko lang maalala kung sino sa kanila, tignan niyo yung mga senator judges, pag nagtanong, yung iba, cross-examination na, yung iba, ganito o ganyan, no? Giving our people the idea or the impression that something irregular is happening here. And I don't blame the Good Justice Defense Council, the Good Justice Cuevas and the lead Defense Council for asking, no? But let me put on the record, this is the rule that we followed during that this Senate, and we weren't here yet, during the era of Estrada impeachment. When we formulated these rules, we were aware that these rules will be applicable to anyone impeached. The Constitution says you can impeach the President, members of the Supreme Court, some people with, for example, the COMELEC chairman, COA chairman, etc. When the ombudsman followed the same process. So, Mr. Chair, in the response to the question of the council, this is a regular procedure for impeachment court. Let's not confuse the procedure in a regular courts of justice in a criminal or civil case with our procedure in a impeachment case, because the rules clearly provide that each senator can ask questions in a two-minute time limit, and I think this is the third time that the good defense counsel questioned some of the questions being asked by Senator Drilon. And in the first instance, the presiding officer already explained their questions are clarificatory questions, but it can be framed in any manner senator judge would like to ask it. So I don't blame you, sir, for asking whose witness is this. Sinundan nyo pa po na witness ba to ni Senator Drilon. Pasensya na po kayo, sir, but medyo na-offend ako doon kasi just because one judge is more active than the other or ask one question that as I said po last time na nagsalita ako dito, di ba sabi ko, maghintay lang ang defense. Kasi pag kayo na magpre-presenta, kung paano ako magtanong na akala nung iba kampi sa prosecution, ganun din ako magtatanong na akala ng iba kampi ako sa defense naman, dahil gusto ko malaman yung katotohanan. But that's our right under the rules. Hindi to ordinary criminal, hindi to ordinary, this is not a court of justice wherein we follow strictly the rules in criminal or civil cases, sir. Dito, magtatanong talaga ang senator judges. Lastly, the good judge, Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago, mentioned the first time she stood up that judges also ask questions like this, and that is the prerogative of the judge, and that was repeated by our presiding officer. So sana po masettle natin to, pero sana hindi na po ganun ang ano natin pag nagtatanong yung isang senator judge.
Wala po kaming hindi
just to finish this discussion. Precisely, I ask a law firm to research for me the powers of the nature and powers of a grand jury, because I remember that under American law, The House of Representatives in conducting an inquiry and in determining the sufficiency of that inquiry to warrant the filing of articles of impeachment.